Next, we're going to talk about the multiplier effect. So what is a multiplier effect? By definition, the multiplier effect is the idea that one additional dollar of expenditure will result in the creation of more than just $1 worth of real GDP. So how does that work? Here is an example. Suppose Justin, he designs cars for a living. And suppose he receives his first installment of car designing service, say $111, and he spent a portion of it, say 90% of it, which is $100. He spent this $100 on Kobe's handmade furniture store. So here, Justin spending $100 will become Kobe's income. Suppose after receiving this $100 for his furniture, Kobe spends a portion of it, say $90, on say Adriana's fitness center for a 2 month membership. So now Kobe's spending will become Adriana's income. Now Adriana, suppose she spent a portion of it, also 90%, say $81 on Home Depot. And this process is going to continue. So you can see that initially Justin spent $100, but then the spending continues, so our total GDP generated was 100 plus 90 plus 81 and so on and so forth. So eventually the GDP generated was $1,000 instead of just 100. So 100 was initial spending, but the GDP generated was $1,000. That is the idea of the multiplier effect. Here is how we calculate the expenditure multiplier. The expenditure multiplier is equal to 1 over 1 minus MPC. But then 1 minus MPC is also equal to MPS. So we know that the expenditure multiplier is also equal to 1 divided by MPS. Now the change in GDP is equal to the expenditure multiplier times the change of expenditure. So suppose that our MPC is equal to 0.9, then our expenditure multiplier will be equal to 1 divided by 1 minus 0.9, or 1 divided by 0.1, which is equal to 10. So your expenditure multiplier will be equal to 10 if your MPC is equal to 0.9. Suppose the government expenditure goes up by 100 million. Now, how would that increase our GDP? So the change in GDP, so delta Y is a change in GDP, is equal to the expenditure multiplier times the change in expenditures. So that will be 10 times 100 million, which gives you 1 billion. Now, practice makes perfect. So here is a practice question. Suppose MPC is equal to 0.75. And the government spending increases by 2 million. So here are two questions. First, calculate the expenditure multiplier. Second, how would the government spending increase affect our GDP? Meaning, would our GDP go up or down and by how much? So please pause the video here and try to work on this question yourself, and then we can compare answers. Now, suppose you're done, we can compare our answers. Here is a solution to the problem. So we know multiplier is equal to 1 divided by MPS. And our MPC is 0.75. So our MPS is equal to 1 minus 0.75. That gives you 0.25. And as a result, your multiplier is equal to 1 divided by 0.25, which gives you 4. So that's your multiplier, 4. Now your government spending increases by 2 million. Therefore, that's going to increase our GDP. By how much? By multiplier times the change in expenditure. So our multiplier is equal to 4, and our government spending increases by 2 million. And therefore, our GDP is going to go up by 8 million. 4 times 2 is equal to 8 million. Let's try another question. Suppose your MPC is equal to 0.8 and the government cuts spending by 5 billion. Question 1, calculate the expenditure multiplier. And question 2, how would the government spending cut affect GDP? In particular, would the GDP go up or down, and by how much? So pause the video and work on this question. So here is the solution. Your expenditure multiplier is equal to 1 over MPS, and your MPS is equal to 1 minus 0.8, so your MPS is equal to 0.2. And as a result, your expenditure multiplier is equal to 1 over 0.2, that gives you 5. So 5 is your expenditure multiplier. How would the government spending cut affect our GDP? So we know the change in GDP is equal to our expenditure multiplier times the change in expenditure, which is equal to 5 times your spending cut 5 billion, so that's negative 5 billion. Then you get negative 25 billion. So your GDP will go down by 25 billion as a result of the government spending cut. And therefore, you know, the Congress has a tremendous influence on our economy.